Hello, everyone. Welcome to our session today about Edge ML AI acceleration for autonomous driver assistance systems. Really exciting area to be talking about, just edge computing. We have four sections we're going to talk about. We're going to talk about defining the edge, all the innovations happening there, why it's such an interesting time, and frankly, how the edge and the cloud are getting a lot closer together. We're going to dive into ADAS systems itself, awesome, you know, kind of safety capabilities kind of coming out of the pipe. I'm going to describe a little bit about how these systems are built and why the cloud and, you know, your car are getting a lot closer together and how this development is happening with edge AI, ML, you know, kind of technologies. And then we're going to leave you with some information to follow up if you want to get more information about this area or other areas related to edge and the Google distributed cloud. So my name is Brian Schwartz. I'm a director of product management here in Google Cloud. I focus on the infrastructure as a service portfolio, and I am super excited to be joined by Abhishek, our subject matter expert here. Abhishek, why don't you introduce yourself?
Thank you, Brian. Abhishek Lal here. Very nice to meet everyone. I'm a product manager with Google Cloud Storage. I focus on all the appliances offerings. So this is infrastructure that we ship to customer locations for transfers, for gateways, and edge compute.
All right, let's hop into the topic itself, and let's talk about edge computing and why it's so interesting and some of the use cases. And Abhishek, obviously, you talk to a lot of, you know, kind of customers and people in vertical industries kind of building out this technology. Give us some of the examples and, you know, things you've heard about why it's such an interesting area and some of the ideas people have.
Absolutely. Across many industry verticals, our customers are looking to delight end users with differentiated customer experiences. And there is a growing expectation that consumers can be better served is if every interaction is personalized for their needs. To do this, however, requires a ton of people, process, tools, advances to happen. And that's where they're looking to Google to partner in the entire journey of this advancements. Customer interactions takes place in offices, retail stores, and theme parks, and all the cloud services that are right now in data centers need to extend to these locations to really provide all of the improvements for customer experiences. Operational improvements also can have a significant impact here. So in factories, exchanges, hospitals, local cloud computing and services can have those operational efficiencies really show up.
What are some of the technologies you think are really impacting this area, Abhishek?
Yeah, the key customer priorities we are seeing is that software is a key differentiator. So if you look at the number of mechanical systems in a car that are now powered by software, it constantly keeps increasing. So customers need to be able to capitalize on these autonomous driving assistance systems and others by connecting this software and really creating a lot of value. The second one is innovation and collaboration. So increasing the speed of innovation for an enterprise allows them to sense, learn, and react faster to their customer needs. And doing that where they can share data, work with partners, work with startups, ISVs, is really what is needed to accelerate and differentiate. Digitization means a lot of sensor data is being generated. Video is a universal sensor, but capturing it, processing it, inferring large amounts of video signal has latency and bandwidth challenges which customers need to address. And finally, ML and AI is what the new software for inference and analytics is being trained and developed and look like. So having a whole CI/CD development pipeline for ML and AI all the way to edge inference to cloud-based training is a key ask.
Let's hop into ADAS itself. And it's such a fun area to talk about. So much safety advances to be had. You know, most people are familiar with adaptive cruise control and some of the earliest stages of this. But let's hop into some of the examples and use cases of how these technologies are actually being developed and some of the more sophisticated stuff that's coming down the pipe. So why don't you talk to us a little bit about Nirav, Abhishek. Obviously, you've spent some time working with them. They're an interesting and fun and innovative company. Give us a sense of what they're doing.
Yeah, Nirav is innovating a lot in this space. They collect data from a lot of remote environments like vehicle depots, which may not have the same consistent networking and storage capabilities which you expect in a data center. So for all this unstructured data that is being generated, we provided transfer appliances to quickly offload that data when these rovers and vehicles are at the depot. Once that data is collected, it can either be locally processed or transferred over high speed connections. And in some cases, if it's a location which is not well connected, they can physically ship the appliance to get the data in the cloud. So this allows for archival, this allows for processing and right-sizing the data storage for their processing needs.
Yeah, it's so interesting to see, you know, the picture of a autonomous delivery system here. But also, let's pop back and talk a little bit about the technology that kind of underpins these things, not just for Nirav, but just kind of more generically across the autonomous kind of vehicle area. I love this picture because it's a real kind of architecture picture of kind of how these systems are built. Can you just kind of talk us through it, you know, kind of left to right, Abhishek, on how the cloud and the edge are really kind of becoming one? I think it's really well summarized on this picture.
Absolutely. So let's start with the vehicle. And this can be a rover, a drone, or an autonomous ADAS
development.
Could
be a ship or a train. Could be a lot of things, but it's just interesting.
Absolutely.
At the edge.
So a lot of, and the far edge. So a lot of data is being generated. There are lots of sensors there. So right there, the in-vehicle appliance can collect that data and store it for local processing. The containerized solutions deployed there can aggregate, transform, filter, and infer the videos and the data generated to find events as well as to detect what is the most desirable data to be captured there. If there is a little bit of a 4G or a 5G, you know, pipe connection, that can be real-time transmitted to the cloud, and that way the research team can see in real-time all the fleet data and events that are being generated. Now, once that processing is done and the vehicle comes back, there's an opportunity to offload that from then the vehicle into hybrid transfer appliances or local storage, where again, more processing can happen at the depot or with larger connections like dedicated interconnect, the data can be moved back to data centers and the cloud. Now, in the cloud itself, you have access to the entire platform where you have ML model development, simulations, or prepare and labeling, as well as analytic services, all of them powered by the right storage offerings, so that you can make the full use of the cloud services.
Yeah, every time I see a demo and some of the scenarios that they've developed, man, it kind of blows my mind on how sophisticated AI is getting. And obviously, it's such a good prowess for Google as a whole and for, you know, available inside Google Cloud. I think it really meshes well with this area of the GDC Edge Appliance. They're really just kind of meant for each other. Now let's talk a little bit more about some of the deployments. And obviously, let's pop back outside of ADAS for a minute and talk about some of the other solutions that, you know, you've seen that this Edge Appliance could really be applied to.
We've worked with a lot of customers, Brian, and in the healthcare space, for example, there are CT scanners and other medical devices which generate images and very, very high volume data, which can be captured there and then moved to the cloud or be locally inferred and processed to generate local intelligence. In manufacturing, there is a lot of opportunity in factories and warehouses to improve operational efficiency. This can be visual inspection of the product, whereby you are looking at very high-speed cameras and doing defect detection, all the way to regular surveillance cameras doing hazard detection or safety violations in there. And then finally, from a media perspective, there are both opportunities on the collection side in studios, in remote locations where video is being recorded, as well as once it has been processed to go distribute that media, whether it be to TV stations or whether it be to processing locations, which may be needed. So across the board, a ton of opportunities where customers need to capture, locally process, bring to the cloud, and then distribute applications where appliances are valuable.
Yeah, you know, one of the things somebody said to me about AI once is that it's really like incorporating like expertise, like human expertise, and applying it at a particular point where the experts are not actually present. And when you think about that in healthcare, think about like the quality of the world's doctors being applied to, you know, your MRI or your X-ray, or, you know, obviously in manufacturing or in media, like just not having to spend all the time and people money to, you know, improve quality of supply chain or safety in a factory. You know, it's just incredible to think about some of the values that these things are going to provide over time. Let's get a little bit more into the GDC Edge Appliance itself. Let's talk about the requirements for it and a little bit more of the technology so people can really ground themselves in kind of how these things, you know, kind of are deployed. So talk us through a little bit about what is the GDC Edge Appliance.
Absolutely. So the Edge Appliance is one of the offerings in our Edge portfolio. Like I said, it ranges from racks all the way down to these single node appliances. It is a fully managed platform, which means hardware, software, operations, everything is managed by Google. And it is shipped to customer locations where it can then provide local compute and services. The key part here is that the solutions that customers want to bring on the appliance now benefit from having edge nodes show up right in their GKE hub as the as if they were another connected cluster. If we go dive a little bit deeper now into the customer experience, you order the appliance and it comes configured for you with all the bucket, destination, storage information, credentials on the box. The first thing we do is, of course, attest and validate the appliance. Because these appliances are in far edge locations, they are vulnerable to hardware or software attacks. So we make sure everything is pristine, nothing has been tampered with. And from there on, the Anthos cluster is installed and connected back to GKE Hub. All the support needed, whether it be troubleshooting, whether it be updates, patches, are all done through Google support and when the appliances are connected. So it's an occasionally connected model. The appliances can function while disconnected, but whenever they are, they get all the updates and patches from the cloud control plane.
Talk to me a little bit about some of the partners and just the technology. How do you think that those containers are going to get developed over time?
Oh, absolutely. So the appliances are a great way to accelerate development of these solutions. You can imagine that customers would want to use Google solutions, first party, like a cloud, call center AI, or develop their own from in-house teams to build solutions. Or a ton of partners have industry-specific knowledge, MLIAI-specific knowledge, which they can bring to bear for these solutions. So you can quickly order appliances, have the solution, try it out, and then really see on an ongoing basis a SaaS-like consumption model develop where you have a marketplace of solutions and you can go and deploy them. And all these vendors, just like they have in the cloud, whether it's first-party SaaS or third-party SaaS, which you're consuming, can now extend to all the edge locations.
Yeah, it's just such an area that's ripe for innovation from so many different types of organizations, whether it be, you know, Google, customers themselves developing, partners, you know, and SaaS companies investing in these, kind of more distributed or hybrid systems. It's just man, it's fascinating to think about the opportunities ahead. Awesome. Well, thanks, Abhishek. And thank you all for joining the session today. Hope it was really interesting. Hope it gave you a sense of kind of where the technology is today, but also where it's going and all the cool and interesting use cases it's going to be applied to in the coming months and quarters and years, and where to get more information. So again, thank you so much. Appreciate all of your time. And Google looks forward to partnering with you in the future. Thank you.
Thank you.